to do something. Wise will only see they cannot become a part, or they cannot participate, or cannot become an accessory to any activity. That is also called karaka. Or karaka also means that it brings about the kriya. So, anyway, so tadeva sputayati nahi iti, says Vibhashya, nahi jnaya prapto vinashah kritakasya vachana shateyanapi वारयितुं शक्यते वचनस्य यथा प्राप्तार्थ ज्ञापकत्वा न्याय प्राप्तो विनाशः. वड न्याय प्राप्त पुटनु न्याय अनुमानम. सो यत् कृतकं तन्नित्यं तदनित्यं, यत् कृतकं तदनित्यं. दैट्स न्याय. सो न्याय प्राप्तो विनाशः. And the drishti also is what? Karyabhuta drishti, therefore vinashini. It must suffer from, it must ultimately perish. So jnaya prapto vinasha kritakasya karyasya. So kritakasya jnaya prapto vinasha. Anything that is created must necessarily come to an end. That vachana shatena abhi varitum nashakyade. That cannot be avoided by even hundreds of words of shruti. They cannot avoid the destruction of something that is created. That way these fellows are like logicians only. They also refuse to accept anything that is outside the logic. That is the best. Shruti, to understand the Shruti, it is the best to do this. Otherwise Shruti will not remain pramana. Oh, because Shastra says. That's why. That means you won't apply your buddhi. But the reason for the discussion is that it is true that we take what Shastra says as pramana. At the same time, we want to understand it. That our buddhi also must support. It must be in keeping with reasoning. It is not a product of reasoning, but must be in keeping with reasoning. If what the Shastra says also is unreasonable, then a Vedantin will have a problem. Devotees will not have a problem, but this Vedantins will have a problem. They are not rationalists, really. But they are at least what we call, they accept the need of reasoning. Rationalists are those who want to establish everything by rationalism or reason. No. Vedantists are no way. By the same time, they see the role of reasoning. The importance of reasoning. That's what. Just because scripture says, so what? Not that we have disrespect for it. We don't say, just because scripture says, so what? No, we don't say that. Oh, scripture says that. Wait a minute. That means we must pay attention, right? But what it says doesn't seem to make sense. But it should make sense. That's called Shraddha. Shraddha is, it must, Shastra Vakya says, Satya Buddhyavadhara. That what the Shastra says must be Satyam. So it is that which enables us to deliberate. That what the scripture says must be true. Now, Kathametad Vijaniyam Yamado Yatha Tvamado Puruttavanadi. Arjuna says, Lord, how should I understand that it is you who in the beginning of creation, you imparted this knowledge to Vivaswan, to Surya, the one who is sitting in front of me, how do I understand? I'm sure that what you say is right. But how do I understand? How do I understand that it is reasonably right? And therefore, what the Shruti says, we expect that it must be in keeping with the reason. What the Nayayika says, that it should be out of reason. So that is all science, that is all physical, material stuff. That's all materialist. But we say, materialism means the people, we don't say that they are even accepting Shruti. They are called astikas, but not in the real sense. But we say that the Shruti statement is taken, and then we apply the reason to understand. So, kritakasya nyaya prapto vinashah, vachana shatena vivaritum nashakyade. And so, it must have a different meaning, that's all. Therefore, avinashini must have a different meaning, or the drashti must have a different meaning. Avinashini cannot have a different meaning, therefore, the drashti must have a different meaning, the drashta must have a different meaning. So it is Shraddha that helps the person to be able to see the meaning. Vachanasya yatha praptartha jnapakatvat. So that vachanam, even Shastra vachan also, yatha praptartha jnapakatvat. Vachanam jnapakam natukarakam. Yatha praptartha means what? Earth on the object as it obtains. So as the thing obtains, that is how even the vachanam also will reveal and not in a different way, or it cannot bring about a change in the nature of the things. This footnote number 4 there, yadyapi mananta viruddham artham vachano bodhayati. Yes, that vachanam, these statements of the scriptures also, they do not communicate, or they do not teach us, or they do not delineate something that is contradictory to the pramanam, or the means of knowledge. Tathavitam karodi, this is purvapaksha. Even then, maybe, it actually karodi, na bodhayati, tathavi karodi. So, it is not that the scriptures teach and reveal something that is opposite to the nature, but they change the nature, why not? Iti āśaṅkyāha vachanasya taduktam vārtike. So, they just said, so vachanasya yathā prāptārtha jñāpkattvā taduktam vārtike. Siddhasya vinjakam mānam nadu tatkārakam yatah ukter nāto vināśitvam drashtu drashtirihesyate. Siddhasya vinjakam mānam, mānam is pramānam, it means of knowledge, vinjakam, is that it reveals siddham, what is already obtaining. Siddham means what is already existing. So, pramana means of knowledge is that which just reveals what is already existing. Nadu tat kārakam yata, it doesn't bring into existence something which is not there. That's all. So, pramana or the means of knowledge is that which reveals what is existing and not, it does not bring into existence something which is not there. Like the light will reveal what is there, not that light will bring about the objects that are not there. Uktir nato vināśitvam drashtuhu drashte ihaishyade. So therefore, ataha, so purupaksha, this is the shloka describing purupaksha, ataha, avinash, drashtuhu drashte avinashitvam ukte ihaishyade. Just because ukti, vachana says that, so ukti means vachanam. Iti iha shabda purvadgami bha, what is it? Mana bhumi vishascha ukte vachana. Just because vachanam says doesn't mean that the drashti becomes avinashane. Drashtuhu drashte iha naishyade. Iha shabdaha purvardhagami. Iha uktehe ataha avinashitva. Iha should go to purvardha. Or iha means also siddhasya vinjakam manam nadu tatkargam yataha purvardhagami manabhum vishascha manabhumi. And it's pertaining to manam means pramanam. As the first half said here, you know, that pramanam is that which reveals what is existing and does not bring into existence something which is not there. Here, that's the rule here. Okay. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Daya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Bhadarayanam Sutra Bhashya Krutau Vande Bhagavantau Punah Punah Ishvaro Guru Ratmedi Murti Bheda Vibhagine Yoma Vatvyapta Dehaya Dakshina Murtaye Namaha. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Hari Om. Pashyati Pashyan Vaitanna Pashyati Nahi Drashtur Drashtir Viparilopo Vidyate Avinashitva Natadvidiyamasti Tato Nyadvibhaktam Yad Pashyed Yad Vaitanna Pashyadi Yad Tatra Tat Tatra Sushabto Atmanavai Pashyadi. Idi Yad Janishe. That you think that in the Sushupti, in the deep sleep state, that the Atma does not see anything. Tanna tatha, that is not so. Pashyan vai tanna pashyati. Yataha tatra sarupa chaitanyena sarasakshyatat pashyanne vasan. Because chaitanyam, the consciousness, is the very nature of the self, and therefore, pashyan seeing, neva pashyati, he does not see. So two things are being told, Pashyan and Napashyati. For that the Hetu is given, Nahi Drashtu Drashtehe Viprilobo Vidyate. Because Pashyan, because he sees, because Drashti of the Drashta. So, Drashtuhu Pramatuhuya Sarasakshi Bhuta Drashtehe. The Sarasakshi Bhuta Drashti, the very vision or the very sight of the seer, which is of the nature of illumining everything. Drashtuhu Kutasya Chinmata Rupasya Swarubh Bhutaya Drashtihi. Or Drashti of the nature of Swarubh or the consciousness, which is the very nature of this Kutastha, so Atma is Kutastha or changeless. Tasya Viparilopo, Tasya Viparilopo Navidyade. That Viparilopo Vinashaha. Not possible that that Drashti would ever suffer from a cessation. Agni Ushnatvata. Because as long as the fire is, so long the heat is. Similarly also, as long as Atma is, so long consciousness is. And of course Atma is Avinashi, therefore the consciousness also is Avinashi. So avinashitvat. Nahi drashtuhu drashtehe viprilobo vidyade kasmat avinashitvat. Vinashahetu parinamahinatvat. That hetu which is required for vinasha to take place. For vinasha or destruction to take place, a hetu or the reason is required. That reason must be parinamitvam. The very nature of changing to change, and that changing nature not being there, Atma is avinashi. And therefore, the drishti also is avinashi. Na pasyati vishesh jnana bhavarupa vidya pratignya. That it does not see another pratignya, that there is an absence of vishesh jnanam or particular knowledge. Nadu tad vidyam asti. Tat tatra susuptav atma surupat vidyam nasti. Vidyam pramatra rupam sabhasa tetanyam nasti. So, other than atma, the ego or the very knower, which is nothing but the reflected consciousness, that is not there. Because for the reflection to be there, there must be mind, and the mind itself was merged with its causal avidya or ignorance. Therefore, that ego, in the sense of manifest ego, is not there, and therefore, there is no vishesha jnanam or particular knowledge. Anyaccha atma srubat anyaccha nasti chakshuradi karanam. That is also not there. And also things such as the eyes and the ears and the mind, all of these karana, the instruments that are required for the vishesha jnana to take place, they are also not there. Yat prameyam pramada pramanena pasyet. So, even the object of knowledge is not there, and the means of knowledge also not there, and the knower also is not there. And therefore, this vyavahar of the nature of the knowing, knowledge, etc. can take place, and knower is not there. So, this is the Kandika, and there was a question raised on the page 1127. Nanu evam na pasyadevi susupte janimah yataha na chakshurva manova darshane karanam vyapratamaste. He says, we know. The reason why the Atma, we say that the Atma does not know anything or does not see anything in the state of deep sleep, because for seeing to take place, karana or instruments such as the sense organs of perception, mind are required, and they are not there. Not only are they required, they must be active. And they are not active in the deep sleep state. That is why he does not see. Then he says, no, nahi, kim tarhi. No, that's not so. Then what is it? Pashyanneva bhavati. In fact, Atma remains a seer. I mean, he sees in this deep sleep also. Katham, how? Nahi, ismat, drashtuhu, drushtihi. Drashtuhu, drushtikartuhu. The drashta. Drashta means drushtikarta. That means the one who is agent of seeing. Ya drashtihi. The drashti of the sight that he has. Tasyaha drashtehe viparilopo vinashahana vidyate. And so, that vinasha, that drashti cannot ever be destroyed. Yatha agnehe aushnim yavadvibhavi. Just as the heat of the fire remains as long as the fire is. Tatha ayamatma drashta avinashi. So also the Atma is avinashi. Therefore, the drashti which is nature of the Atma also is avinashi. Yavad drashtu bhavini sa. So Atma being avinashi, drashti, that is consciousness, also is avinashini. The question is raised, nanu vipratashiddhamidam abhidhiyate. On one hand you call him drashta. సో ద్రష్టు దృష్టే విపరిలోకోన విద్యతే ది దృష్టి ఆఫ్ ద సైట్ ఆఫ్ ద సియర్ దట్ డస్ నాట్ ఎవర్ గెట్ డిస్ట్రాయిడ్ బట్ ఆన్ వన్ హ్యాండ్ యూ కాల్ హిమ్ ద్రష్ట ఆఫ్ ద సియర్ ఆన్ ద అదర్ హ్యాండ్ యూ సే ద దృష్టి డస్ నాట్ గెట్ డిస్ట్రాయిడ్ దిస్ ఇస్ కాంట్రడిక్టరీ బికాస్ హూ ఇస్ ద్రష్ట దృష్టిశ్చ ద్రష్టా క్రియతే దృష్టికర్తృత్వాది ద్రష్టా ఇది ఉచ్యతే హూ ఇస్ కాల్డ్ ద్రష్ట హూ ఇస్ కాల్డ్ సియర్ దృష్టికర్త సో వన్ హూ ఇస్ ఏజెంట్ ఆఫ్ సీయింగ్ ఇస్ కాల్డ్ సియర్ దట్ మీన్స్ ద దృష్టి ఇస్ సంథింగ్ దట్ ఇస్ ఆల్వేస్ బ్రాట్ అబౌట్ బై ద ద్రష్ట సో వెదర్ దృష్టి దట్ ఈస్ సీయింగ్ ఇస్ దేర్ ఆర్ నాట్ ఇస్ సంథింగ్ దట్ ఈస్ డిటర్మిన్డ్ బై ద సియర్ సో సియర్ హూ బ్రింగ్స్ అబౌట్ ద యాక్ట్ ఆఫ్ సీయింగ్ క్రియమాణా చ దృష్టి ద్రష్ట క్రియమాణా చ దృష్టి And therefore, drishti of the seeing is something that is brought into existence by the very seer. Navi parilupyate. So, drishti is something, seeing is something that is an act that is brought into existence by the seer. And that which is brought into existence, that which is created and that remains permanent, that is not possible. Iti cha shakyam vaktum. Then tentatively to say, nanu navi parilupyate iti. We says, well, we don't care what you say. Navi parilupyate iti vachanad. All we can say, the Shruti says, navi parilupyate. This drashti of the consciousness, it never gets destroyed. That's all. That's what the Shruti says. It doesn't matter what the reasoning says. Iti vachanad. So it's important. Whether vachanam, whether the words or the statement of the Shruti, can it alter a fact? It says, na vachanasya jnapakatvat. The statement is something that only will reveal the nature of the object, nature of the thing. And so there is no karakam na karakatvam. It cannot alter a fact. It can only reveal a fact. Any means of knowledge will reveal the fact and never alter the fact. Nahi nyaya prapto vinashah kritakasya vachana shatena vivarayutam kriyate shakyate. సో కృతకస్య న్యాయ ప్రాప్తో వినాశః యత్ కృతకం తద్ అనిత్యం సో దట్ విచ్ ఇస్ క్రియేటెడ్ మస్ట్ నెసెసరీలీ బి ఇంపర్మనెంట్ అండ్ దట్ ఇస్ సంథింగ్ దట్ ఇస్ న్యాయ ప్రాప్త సో సంథింగ్ దట్ ఈస్ దట్స్ రీజనబుల్ లాజికల్ దట్స్ వాట్ వి అబ్జర్వ్ వచన శయనాపి వారయం నశక ఇన్ షో దిస్ ఈస్ ద నేచర్ ఆఫ్ థింగ్స్ ఎనీథింగ్ దట్ ఇస్ క్రియేటెడ్ మస్ట్ ఆల్సో గెట్ డిస్ట్రాయిడ్ అట్ సమ్ పాయింట్ ఇన్ టైమ్ దిస్ ఈస్ ద నేచర్ ఆఫ్ థింగ్స్ And this nature of thing cannot be changed even by the Vedas. If Vedas are those ways which are created, so it is based on the knowledge of the Veda that the world is created. So it is said, Yo Brahmanam Vidadhati Purvam, Yo Vai Vedam Sya Prahinoti Tasmai. Lord creates Brahmaji in the beginning of the creation and imparts the knowledge of Vedas to Brahmaji and based on that knowledge, Brahmaji creates the world. And therefore, in fact, that is how the world is created. Now how can it change? So how can these very words change, alter the facts? Cannot alter the facts. Vachanasya yatha praptartha jnapakatvat. Yatha praptartha. Whatever be the mean nature of the thing, yatha praptam jnapakatvat. Vachanam of the words, statements, can only reveal the statement of Shruti. Somebody's, it's not a statement of anyone. Vachanam here means, this Shrutehe Vakyam, the words of Shruti. We are on page 1129. From continuing the second paragraph, says Anandagiri, Kutastha drishti evatra drashtu shabdartha na drishtikarta. What it is that we mean by drashta? Kutastha drishti evatra drashtu shabdartha. Drashtu shabdartha, the meaning of the word drashtu. The meaning of the word drashta is what? Kutastha drishti. By drashta, we do not mean that word in the primary sense, that he is actually a seer, that he sees, no. That is of the nature of seeing. So that kutastha drishti, that the constant, the changeless seeing, the changeless illumination, that is the nature of the self, that is what is meant by drashta here, and not that drashta means an agent of seeing. Na drishtikarta, tan na vipratishedaha. Therefore, there is no vipratishedaha, there is no contradiction in what the Shruti says. It is siddhanta, it is siddhanta. Drashta is in fact drashti alone. Naisha dosha hiti, says Bhashyakara. Naisha dosha aditya adiprakashakatvavata.
दर्शनोपपत्तेः
नैष दोषः इज नॉट द दोष दैट मीन्स दैट द दृष्टि एंड द दृष्टा दैट द साइट ऑफ द सीयर डज नॉट इज परमानेंट देयर इज नो प्रॉब्लम हियर इन दिस पर्टिकुलर केस व्हाई आदित्यादि प्रकाशकत्ववत् दर्शनोपपत्तेः आदित्यादि प्रकाशकत्ववत् Aditya's prakashakatvam. Aditya means the sun. So sun is of the nature, has the nature of illumination. Prakashakatvam. To illumine things is the nature of the sun. So just as the sun is illuminator of the world. Now when you use the word illuminator, means what? The agent of illumination. And whenever we say agent means that some effort is required on the part of that agent. So when we say the sun is illuminator, Vashyakar is going to explain this anyway. But anyway, so our pratyaya is applied there, illuminator. That makes him an agent of illumination, the agent of act of illumination. And therefore, automatically, in that shabda prayoga, in that very use of the expression illuminator, some action of illumination is involved, because to illumine is a kriyapada, is a verb, which presupposes an action. And therefore, if the sun is called illuminator, then the sense that it conveys is that sun makes an effort to illumine. It says, no, adityadi prakashakatvavat. Even though we call sun an illuminator of the world, in fact, there is no effort involved on the part of the sun to illuminate, that the sun is of the nature of illumination. Sun is not an illuminator, to illumine is a nature, and therefore, illumination is the nature of the sun. However, only in a figurative sense we say that the sun illumines the world, because without the sun the world would be dark. And then we say that the sun illumines the world, not that we impute any kind of an agency of illumination in the sun, something like that. So, darshanopattehe. So that kind of darshanam, darshanam is seeing. So, darshanam is in the sense of drashta. Sun also can be called the seer, the witness of the whole world, you can say. But witnessing also is not an act on the part of the sun. By the very act, by the very fact of sun being the nature of brightness, that illumines everything, that he can be figuratively called a witness. That's all. That's what Siddhangi Adityadi Prakashakatvade Yuktam Drishtanam Vyajaste. So Drishtan, they said, Adityadi Prakashakatvat, like the sun is illuminator, that illustration is Vyajaste, explained Vyashakara Yathayati. यथा आदित्यादयः नित्यप्रकाशस्वभाव एव सन्तः स्वाभाविकेन नित्येनैव प्रकाशेन प्रकाशयन्ति यथा आदित्यादयः नित्यप्रकाशस्वभाव एव सन्तः So Adityadaya, just as the sun and other luminaries, sun and the fire and moon and other luminaries, Adityadaya, Nitya Prakasha Svabhavaha Eva Santaha. What is Aditya? Nitya Prakasha Svabhavaha. Aditya is of the nature of all illumination. Nitya Prakasha, always of the nature of brightness. So Aditya, the sun, is the nature, that's what we call luminary, whose nature it is to shine. That's all. So therefore, brightness is the very nature of the sun and other luminaries. Nitya prakasha svabhavaha. That's interesting. Prakasha is the svabhava, and svabhava is nitya. So there, Aditya's sun and the other luminaries are the nature of, so nitya prakasha, all the of the nature of eternal brightness. So, santaha svabhavikena nityeneva prakashena prakashanti. So, when these luminaries illumine, then how do they illumine? Nityena, swabhavikena. That prakasha, the light is, which is very nature, swabhavikena. And that which is a changeless nature. And it is by the light, which is the nature, that they illumine. So illumine, to illumine is the very nature and not an act on the part of Aditya. This is very important. So even though there are verbs, every verb does not necessarily imply an action. There are what we call the verbs of being. And thus, whenever something, so something is. So to be is not, that doesn't involve any kind of an action, it is just the verb of being. And therefore, the sun shines. Even though to shine is a verb, it is not a verb involving any action. It is a verb that reveals the nature. So here also, prakashayati. So when it is said, again, to illumine is not an act on the part of the Aditya and others. It is just to be. So, then says Anandagiri, drishtandevi vipratipannam pratyah. Dushtandevi vipratipannam, even in your dushtand also, in sun, etc., there is also a contradiction there. That is pratyaha. So that is refuted here by Vashyakara, nahi de. Nahi aprakashatmanasantah prakasham kurvantah prakashyante iti uchyante. Kintarhi svabhave naiva nityena prakashena. See, verb, when we say action, action is never, if it is not a nature of, when we say Devadatta is running, so when we say Devadatta is running, so running is not the nature of Devadatta, so Devadatta is a non-runner by nature, is making an effort to run, then when that is not the nature of a thing, then a verb involves an action. Like Devadatta is running. Similarly also, to illumine would have been an act and would involve an effort on the part of the sun if illumination were not the nature of the sun. And then sun did something in order to illumine. Just as to run is not the nature of the Devadatta, and Devadatta does something. So it is said here, it is not that the sun and other luminaries are aprakashatmana, of the nature of non-illumination, they are not bright in nature, prakasham kurvantah, and then do something in order to illumine, like the bulb. So bulb also is not of the nature of illumination, bulb needs to do something to illumine. So bulb is aprakashatmana, santah, bulb and others, you know, and they do something, then that light. So that light cannot be permanent. But that's the light of the bulb is something that is brought into existence. And anything that is brought into existence will someday perish. So that is how, but that's not the case of the sun. That is how, prakasham kurvantaha, prakashandi uchyante. We do know when we say, adityadaha prakashandi, sun and other luminaries illumine, it is not that they sometimes not illumine also. If sometimes you don't do that, and sometimes you do that, then you say that an action is involved. So if there was a time where a state when the sun and others are not illumining, and then now it illumines and says, hey, sun is illumining everything. Now he's talking, now he's running, now he's walking, now he's eating. So sometimes you try the child, you know, to feed him, and then all kinds of things happen, you know, he just runs around and you run after him, and all sorts of things you do. Then you start telling a story or whatever it is, and then he says, and then you feed him, you know. So, all right. And then he starts eating, or whatever. So, now he's eating. So, because otherwise he's not eating also, the thing is, so when something is not doing it sometime, if sun was not illumining or not luminous at a given time, then you can say that, now the sun is luminous, now the sun is shining. So, when we say sun shines, it is not in that sense that we say that sun who does not shine at some time now is shining. Kintari, that when you say that the sun shines or the sun illumines, what do you mean? Svabhaveneva nityena prakashena. It is nitya prakashava svabhava of the sun. So that is what we mean, that it is the nature of the sun to illumine and not that any action is involved. So darshanopattehi iti uktam. Two aspects were there, you see. In the earlier vakya, in the earlier page, adityadi prakashakatvavat darshanopattehe. Adityadi prakashakatvavat is drishtanta. In that statement, two things are involved, drishtanta and hetu. Darshanopattehe, fifth case. Darshanopattehe, that's the hetu. And adityadi prakashakatvavat is the drishtanta. And so, drishtanta is first explained, now the hetu is being explained, and then of course, darshtanta. Darshtanta is atma. So, darshanopattehiti uktam. So, that darshanopatti, that this darshanam is, can be there, seeing can be there, without involving an effort. So who does that? Atma is Darshtanta. And so, Darshtantika Vibhajate. So Darshtantika is Atma. Tathayate. Tatha I am Apyatma. Abhiparalupta Svabhavaya. Drishtya Nityaya. Drashta Iti Ucchate. Tatha I am api atma. Similarly also, this atma too. Avipariluptya svabhava drishtya, svabhavaya drishtya. So, avipariluptya svabhava. So, drishti. Drishti which is of the nature of, that which does not suffer any kind of a cessation. That's all. Viparilopaha. So, viparilopa means destruction or cessation. So, indestructible drishti which is the nature of the atma. So, by that, he is called drishta. So, atma also is called drishta. Not because there is an act of seeing, but because drishti, or to illumine or to see, or consciousness is the very nature. Just as the sun is called the illuminator, because to illumine is its nature. Then, Sri Dhananagiri, Atmanaha Nitya Drishtitve Doshamashankate. That means you can't call him drishta, really. You see, now that means you are saying there is not drishta. And therefore, how can the nitya drishti, how can there be nitya drishti when it's not a drashta in primary sense? Is atma a drashta in the primary sense or not? If he drashta or the seer in the primary sense, then alone you can say that this is the drishti, the sight of the seer. But if atma is not the seer, then you can't say the sight of the seer. The sight of the seer is permanent or eternal, you can't say that because there is no seer. From what you are saying, there is no seer in the primary sense. So this question is raised here. Gaunamati. Gaunam tarhi drashtatvam. So gaunam, gaunam means what? In a secondary sense. Guna. So where there is a guna samanyam, so some two things possess a similar quality. As you said, Devadatta is a lion. So when we say that, some guna, some quality of the lion is found in Devadatta. Therefore, in a secondary sense, we call Devadatta a lion. Therefore, everything about lion cannot be imposed upon or imputed on Devadatta. Similarly also here, you are calling Atma a drashta only in a secondary sense. And therefore, everything that applies to a drashta or a witness or a seer cannot be applied to Atma. Not only that, but say Dhanagiri, Gaunasya Mukhya Apekshatvat. So where is the Devadatta is lion? Then Devadatta is called a lion only in a figurative sense, secondary sense. When can we say that? When there is a real lion. So Devadatta is a lion, so Gauna Prayoga. This Gauna Prayoga is a Prayoga based on Guna, as we say. Simply Devadatta Agnir Manavakaha, it is that example. That example is Agnir Manavaka Hetivata. So a Manavaka means a very bright student, you know. Sometimes a student is so bright and is shining, you see, it's like a fire, you know, it's like a fire. So some brightness with fire, fire is bright, and this boy also has got brightness, so we call him, so he's a fire. But you say he's fire when there is a real fire. So Gauna Prayoga always presupposes a mukhya prayoga. Gauna is based on guna. A secondary use always presupposes a primary use. So that means that there must be fire in a primary sense. Then a secondary sense we can say that this boy is fire. There must be a lion in a primary sense. Then we say that this man is a lion. You know, things like that. So nerves of steel, you know. So nerves cannot be of steel or whatever. But there must be real steel. So in a secondary sense we can say, so, gaunasya mukhya apekshatvat. Gauna always involves, requires, presupposes mukhya or a primary one. Mukhyasya cha anyasya drashtutvasya abhavat. But mukhyasya cha, so where are we? This is the footnote number 6. That's all already. Where are the other footnotes? Footnote number 6. Tarhi. Oh, Gaunam Tarhi. Okay, that's where The first footnote is, you can read that also, Gaunam Tarhidi. Tarhidi, Nitya Drishtitvena, they must be, the words must be together. Nitya Drishtitvena eva Atmana Drishtutve. Gaunam Tarhidi, Tarhidi means what? Then means what? Nitya Drishtitvena eva Atmana Drishtutve. If you call Atma a drashta or a seer, because consciousness or seeing is a nature, then Gaunam Drashtutvam, then Atma cannot be called drashta or a seer in the primary sense. What is Gaunam? Vina vikaram prakashakatvam. So, prakashakatvam is there, but vina vikaram, a drashta is the one who must undergo a change. Seer undergoes a change, or a witness undergo the change, illuminator also undergo the change, but here this illuminator does not undergo a change, so vina vikaram prakashakatvam. So then vikara sahidam prakashakatvam, that will be primary drashta, but vina vikara prakashakatvam is secondary drashta. Agnir manavaka itivat gaunam evasyat, and therefore that the atma is a drashta or a seer is in a secondary sense, like this boy is fire. No mukhya mityashaya, therefore there is no mukhya primary, so Atma is not the drashta in a primary sense. That means there must be primary drashta. There must be primary drashta, drashta in a primary sense, with reference to whom you can call Atma a drashta in the secondary sense. Therefore Anandagiri said, Gaunasya mukhya apekshatvat mukhyasya cha. Footnote number 6, mukhyasya cha anyasya di vikara rupasya. That another drashta, who is of the nature of vikara, who is changing, that kind of drashta in a primary sense must be there, then Atma can be called drashta in a secondary sense. So Anandagiri says, mukhyasya cha anyasya drashtutvasya abhavad. Now, drashtutvasya abhavad, again footnote number 7, drashtutvasya abhavad adi. Anyway, so read that sentence in Anandagiri, anyasya drashtutvasya abhavad maevam. So another drashta is not there, therefore Atma cannot be called the drashta even in the secondary sense. So looking at footnote number 7, drashtutvasya bhavad. Now going to footnote number 7, drashtutvasya bhavadidi. Okay. The footnote says, nanu asteva pramatari. జట్లు ఊచూర హ్యాండ్ రాకోను జట్లు నను అస్తేవ ప్రమాతరి దర్శన క్రియాకర్తృత్వం వికారూపం ముఖ్యం ద్రష్టృత్వం ఇది చేత్ నను క్వశ్చన్ ఇస్ అస్తేవ ప్రమాతరి సి వి హ్ ఎ ప్రమాద ప్రమాద మీన్స్ నోవర్ అస్తేవ ప్రమాతరి వెన్ దిస్ ప్రమాద ద నోవర్ ఇస్ దేర్ దర్శన క్రియాకర్తృత్వం వికారూపం ముఖ్యం ద్రష్టృత్వం ఇది చేత్. Now they say, yes, there is a mukhya drashta, there is a seer in the primary sense, this pramata, the knower, is a drashta. So ego, let us say, ego, which assumes the role of a knower, he is a drashta or a seer in the primary sense. So, pramatari, darshana kriya kartratvam, vikara rupam, mukhyam drashtutvam. That pramata is a drashta in a primary sense, because vikara rupam, that involves a change in pramata, it's like this. So the seer changes with reference to what is seen. Even the seer also changes. Now I am a seer of a tree, then I am a seer of a fan, then I am a seer of a book. So what we call drashta undergo the change with reference to drishya. That is why we say drashta also is vikari. So there is a sympathetic change in the seer with reference to the changes taking place in what is seen. And that's how the seer also is changing. Now how can you call Atma a seer when it doesn't change? So what is seen or what is illumined keeps on changing, and when the seer illuminator does not change, how can you call him a seer in the primary sense? So let us say that the pramada, the knower, can be called a seer in the primary sense. Asti eva. Asti eva. So there is in fact, no? Asti eva, pramadari, darshana kriyakartrutvam, vikarupam, mukhyam drashtutvam. Yeah. So they say, yes, there is in fact mukhyam drashtutvam. There is a drashtutvam of the seerness in a primary sense in pramadari, in the pramada. So in the pramat or the knower, there is this drashtutvam or this seeing in the primary sense. Vikara rupam kartrutvam mukhyamasti. So somebody said that yes, there is a primary drashta. That is called pramata. With reference to whom, atma is called drashta in a secondary sense. Iti chet, but Siddhanti doesn't like this. Siddhanti wants to call atma the drashta in primary sense. That atma is the seer in the primary sense. Not this pramata, not this shiravada, not this ahankara. Otherwise, yes, it is true. That as we understand, the ahankara, meaning pramata, the knower, is indeed a seer in the primary sense, because that is called a knower who undergoes sympathetic change with reference to changes taking place in what is known. And in that sense, of course, the pramata is a knower in the primary sense. So, vikara rupam drashtrutvam asti pramatari is there. Iti chet, if this was, no, he says, no, not so. Darshanasya nitya chidrupataya kriyatva abhavena tat kartrutvasya kutravi asambhavad darshanopadehe vrittiheva chakshurade janyataya pramadani tatha pratitihi aupadhiki. He says, no, darshanasya nitya chidrupataya. What is darshanam? What is seeing is always of nature of nitya chidrupataya. It is the nature of consciousness that is permanent or eternal. So seeing, wherever it is, wherever any seeing is involved, it is always the consciousness that is changeless and eternal. So nitya chidrupataya darshanasya kriyato abhavena. So in that darshanam or in that seeing on the part of the consciousness that is changeless, no kriya or no change is involved, no action is involved. Tat kartratvasya kutrabi asambhavat. So kriyatva bhavena, kriya is not involved, therefore kartratvasya, there cannot be karta. So since that nitya kutastha drishti, the consciousness that is changeless, that is what we call the seeing. And that being changeless, therefore, there cannot be a karta or, a drashta or a seer which undergoes change. Kutrapyasama. That means that there cannot be a changing drashta. Even though you say that drashta must be the one who undergoes the change, we say that drashta cannot undergo the change for the simple reason that drashti is always kutastha chidru. And therefore, the drashti is always changeless consciousness. Therefore, there cannot be a drashta, changing drashta. Even primary drashta also is changeless, not changing. That is not right, but the pramata does undergo change. Then he says here, darshanopadehe vrittiheva chakshuradi janyataya pramatari tatha pratitihi aupadhiki. Yes, there is a change in pramata, all right. Oh. So, there is a change in pramata, all right. Now I was wondering why that fan is not working, but that face was not working, all right. So, darshanopadehe vrittehe. So, it's called darshanopadhi. So, when darshana of the seeing takes place, then there is a vritti. So, chakshushi vritti, for example, when I see with my eyes, a chakshushi vritti, a vritti or a thought form, the nature of that object is created. So, darshanopadehe vrittehe. The vritti becomes an upadhi. So when you say that there is a change in the drashta, where does the change take place? The change really takes place in the vritti. So now there is the chakshushi vritti, so when I see a tree, then the vritti of the nature of tree takes place, and another object is there. So as the objects change, the vrittis keep on changing. And that change happening in the vritti is only imputed on the drashta. So when you say that drashta is changing, when you say pramata is changing, that change in the pramata is imagined to be there only because the vritti keeps on changing. So darshanopadehe vrittehe. Whenever darshanam takes place, there is a vritti which is upadhi, which is the unusual condition happening there. Chakshuradi janyataya. So chakshu shrotram, etc., which are the means of perception. So they bring about different vrittis as the objects of perception keep on changing. So because of the chakshu, shrotram, etc., the perception takes place, and so the vrittis take place inside in corresponding to the objects. So the vrittis keep on changing, and that change happening in the vritti, Like ghatajnanam, patajnanam, so ghatakaravatti, patakaravatti, these vrittis keep on changing. As the objects of perception keep on changing, and that change happening in the vritti is imputed upon pramata. So pramatari tatha pratipihi. That we say the pramata is changing, that is what? Aupadiki. That change taking place in the drashta, the pramata, is not an order itself on account of upadhi. Just as in a crystal. The changes in the colors of the crystal take place not on account of itself, on account of the object which is beside place in the vicinity of the crystal. And so, if one does not know the nature of the crystal, one may think the crystal is changing. But the pramata or the knower is changing. But even the vastu tastu, in reality indeed, however, vrittehe api vastu pramana sambandha matra adhina janyataya. Even vritti also. Vrittehe janyataya. Vritti, like ghatakar vritti, patakar vritti also is brought about. Vastu pramana sambandha. So when does the vritti take place? When does ghatakar vritti take place? Vastu and pramana sambandha. Vastu is ghata here, and pramana is my eyes, the object, sense of perception, sambandha. When the association or contact gets established between the means of knowledge and the object of knowledge, vastu pramana sambandha matra adhina janmataya, then the ghatakar vritti is born. The only reason why the ghatakar vritti is born is because of the context of the eyes in this case, and pramanam, and the vastu which is ghata here. So, vastu, pramana, sambandha, matra. There is no other reason for that vritti to arise. In fact, no activity is involved even in arising of that vritti. The idea is that when ghatakara vritti takes place, no will is involved. No effort is involved on the part of the pramata for ghatakara vritti to take place. If an effort was involved on the part of the pramata or the knower for that vritti to take place, then you can say knower is changing. But here, the vritti takes place not because of the effort on the part of the knower. Vritti takes place merely as a consequence of the contact of the pramana, the means of knowing, and the object of knowledge. So, vastu pramana sambandha matra adhina. No effort is involved there. That sambandha alone brings about the vritti. Smatra adhina janmataya na pramatra kritisadhyatvam vrittehe api. So even in vritti also, na pramātra kriti sādhyatvam, it is not the pramātra, the knower, that kriti means performs an action, or some will or effort is involved in the part of the pramātra, then vritti is born. That is not so. Then in the vritti also, vritti is not born because of an effort on the part of the pramātra. Kutastaram chiddarshanasya pramām prati kartrutva vyavharastu. So sādhyatvam kutastaram chiddarshanasya pramam prati kartrutva vyavharah. However, you still call him pramata. Pramata is what? Pramakarta, you can say. So pramata. Pramata is knower. So that knower also are picked and all there. So some kartrutva, some agency is involved. So chiddarshanasya pramam prati kartrutva vyavharastu. Chiddarshanam. In fact, darshanam is the nature of merely consciousness. And pramam is the knowledge. So knowledge of cognition. So cognition of ghatapada etc. take place. And in the cognition of ghatapada etc. take place, then this consciousness, also we call him consciousness, we call him seer, we call him witness. In only in what sense? So kartrutva vyavahara, that kartrutva, the witness, that us as also is there, you know. So that also means agent. Even that vyavahara also is pramautpatya anukula vishendriya sambandha anukula kritimatvat. So pramautpatya anukula, very beautiful, you see, very beautiful expression. There are all the expressions coming from the Nyaya Shastra, you know. And how nicely they are able to express things in very compact and very precise way. So precision and compactness, brevity, both are there in the Nyaya. Because if you try to become elaborate, then you can make a mistake. So you must be brief. At the same time, you must be precise. At the same time, you must express everything that is to be expressed. Just because you're brief doesn't mean just you say something, you know, and leave things out. No, without leaving things out, being brief and being precise. So, prama utpatti anukula. So, prama utpatti. Prama means cognition. So, prama utpatti, for the cognition, like ghatajnanam to take place, perception of knowledge to take place, anukula, vishayendriya sambandha. So, the vishayendriya sambandha. Vishaya and indriya. Ghata and the eyes, sambandha, the association between these two, contact between the two must take place. So that is prama utpatti anukula sambandha. So that sambandha, the contact that takes place between vishaya and the indriya, that becomes anukula vyapara, that becomes anukula or conducive for the prama or the cognition to take place. So prama utpatti anukula vishayendriya sambandha anukula krutimatvat. All that we do is, as we said yesterday, an effort is involved, not in the knowledge to take place, but in creating the condition for the knowledge to take place. That cognition of a pot can take place only when the contact between the object, namely pot, and the means of knowing is established. And that is where an effort is involved. So if Pramata, the knower, makes an effort in knowing, what is the effort? There is no effort involved in knowing. Effort is involved merely in establishing contact. Such contact which is conducive for that prama or cognition to take place. That's all. But no effort is involved actually in prama. So, sambandha anukula krutimatvad pramatari aupacharika eva kartrut pramatari kartrut vyavahara. That pramata is also called a pramata. That is called the agent of seeing, in only in the sense that his action is involved only in bringing about the contact and not in actually knowledge. This is very important, of course, that jnanam vastu tantram. Knowledge always is determined by the vastu and is not determined by the knower. So knower has no freedom in determining the form of knowledge. So the knowledge is determined by the object of knowledge, except that. That knowledge or cognition can take place only when appropriate contact. Not merely contact, but an appropriate, adequate contact between the means of knowledge and the object of knowledge established, and that is where the effort is involved. And therefore, pramātari api kartrutva vyaharastu aupacharik haiva pramām prapi. And so that pramāta also is called pramāta with reference to pramā only in a secondary sense. So in prama, and in fact, therefore, in the cognition, action is never involved. Therefore, what you call primary drashta or a primary pramata also does not involve an action. Therefore, as far as prama is concerned, action is not involved. Therefore, atma is kutastha drashti can be pramata in a primary sense, because in knowing, never an action is involved. Even while you think the action is involved, there also no real action is involved, as far as knowing is concerned. Then the footnote continues, kincha chetanas chetananam ityadi srutehe atma drashtutva adhinameva pramatuhu drashtutvam nitya anityanam chetana chetananam. Kathopanishad. Atma is nitya, or nityo nityanam also, nitya anityanam. So one who is a nitya, atma of all the anitya upadis, chetanas chetananam, so one is the very source of consciousness of all the beings who are conscious or sentient. So one is the very source of consciousness of all the conscious beings. So if pramata is a conscious being, if ahankara or chidavada is a conscious being, it is not because of itself. Chetanas chetananam, the consciousness which is there in pramata or knower is only because of the atma. It is shrutehe, atma drashtutva adhinameva pramadhu drashtutvam. So the drashtutvam, the seeing of the pramata also is only because of atma and not because of itself, because pramata is jada. And anything, then it's atma alone that imparts consciousness to anybody, everything. Evam chasati atma drashtutvam gaunam. When this is so, then for you to say atma drashtutvam gaunam, the seeing of the atma is gauna, is secondary. Pramatuscha tanmukhyam. And the seeing of the pramata is mukhya. Vadan, grivastha mukhaya gauratvam gaunam, दर्पणस्तमुखगौरत्वं च मुख्यम्। दिस लाइक सेइंग दैट ग्रीवास्तमुखगौरत्वं गौणम्। द फेयरनेस ऑफ द हेड, द फेयरनेस ऑफ द फेस विच इज ऑन माय शोल्डर, सो फेयरनेस ऑफ द फेस विच ऑन माय शोल्डर और माय नेक, दैट फेयरनेस इज सेकेंडरी एंड दर्पणस्तमुखगौरत्वं मुख्यम्। And the fairness of the face appearing in the mirror is primary. This is what, when you say the pramata is the drashta in a primary sense and atma is the drashta in a secondary sense, it is comparable to saying this, that my face, no, wow, gauratva, my face, the face in the mirror is a primary face and face on my shoulder or my neck is secondary. This is what it amounts. So what is primary is called secondary and what is secondary is called primary, you don't realize it. So when you call pramada a primary drashta and atma secondary drashta, this is what it amounts to. Bhruvata tulyaha sahakalu upekshaniya eva. And therefore, when this fellow says that upekshaniya, he must be in fact disregarded. He must be ignored. Upekshaniya eva parikshakanam apadyeta. And therefore, for parikshakanam, so those people who do pariksha, those people who in fact examine everything properly, for them this person will only will attain the status of being ignored. Should not pay much attention to this kind of things for by the parikshakas. So you should not exert yourself also to refute these people. That's the idea, you know, because it's, you know, they don't even deserve that, you know, for you to make an effort to refute them, even that is also not necessary. Upekshaniya. Alright, so this is all gaunam and mukhyam. The idea is that there is only drashta and mukhya drashta. There is no gauna drashta at all, that's all. And so in darshanam, never an effort is involved. It is always kutasa drashti with always darshanam. What does it mean? So whenever any cognition takes place, one can meditate upon atma. Any cognition takes place, that kutasa drashti is involved. And so that is why they always just shift the focus of attention. Yen manasana manute, yen ahur manomatam. That which cannot be thought of by the mind, but that because of which the mind thinks. Yet chakshushana pashyati, yen chakshumshi pashyati. That which cannot be perceived by the eyes, but that because of which they perceive the eyes. So the attention is to be shifted from what is perceived to that because of which the perception takes place. Pratibodha viditam matam. So bodha, the various vrittis keep on arising in the mind. So rather than paying attention to vritti, which is where we of course get preoccupied, pay attention to that because of which the vritti is illumined, that's all. And so in every cognition, atma is always involved, kutas drashti. Even in pramada also, the reason that is called pramada is because primarily atma alone is the pramada, atma alone is the seer. Except that seer, that arpratya or the drashta, the trispratya is only a figurative sense. Because in seeing, action is never involved. So this is the whole idea here. So gaunasya, Anandagiri said, gaunasya mukhya pekshatvat. Mukhyasya cha anyasya drashtutvasya abhavat. Now if atma is thus seer in the gauna or secondary sense, there is no primary seer. And therefore, mayavam. That's what the Siddhanta says. You can call Atma the seer in the secondary sense, provided there was a seer in the primary sense. But there is no other seer. And there is no other kind of seeing, both ways. There is no other seer, and there is no other kind of seeing also. If there was other kind of seeing, if Atma saw in one way and the second way also, then with reference to one kind of seeing, other kind of seeing can be called secondary. But there is no other kind of seeing also. Mayavam iti uttaramaha. Therefore, your contention is not right. That's how the reply is given. Na ityadina. Na evameva mukhyatva upapattehe. This is so wonderful, you know. It's brilliant. Na, not so that this seeing is secondary, no. Evameva, it is only in this manner. Mukhyatva upapattehe. It is in this manner that the primary seeing also is tenable. And that this seeing of the Atma cannot be called secondary. Tameva upattim upadashayati upapattehe. It's tenable, reasonable, in keeping with the reason. Tame Upattim, that very reasoning now, Upadashayati Bhashyakara demonstrates here, shows. Yadihi Pyadya. Yadihi Anyathapi Atmanah Drashtratvam Drishtam Tada Asya Drashtratvasya Gaunatvam Nato Atmanah Anyah Darshana Prakara Asti. Yadihi, indeed, if Anyathavi Atmanah Drashtutvam Drishtam. So Atmanah in which case is an interesting thing. Atmanah can be fifth case as well as sixth case. Atmanah Drashtutvam Drishtam. If the sixth case is taken, then if Atma were seeing in a manner different from this, Atmanah Anyathavi Drashtutvam Drishtam. If Atma were seeing in a manner different from this kind of seeing, footnote number 3, drishtam bhavet, tada asya kutastha drishtirupasya drishtutvasya gaunatvam. Then, if Atma was seeing also in a changing way, then his change in a seeing would be called gaunam. So, tada asya drishtutvasya gaunatvam. This kind of seeing, kutastha drishtutvam, would be gaunam, had there been vikari drishtutvam. So if Atma were seeing in a changing manner, then the changeless seeing would be called secondary. Footnote 5. Syat. Well, Gaunatvam Syat. Nadu. Atmanah Anyah Darshan Prakara Asti. But Atma does not have any other way of seeing. Atmanah Anyah Darshan Prakara Nasti. Atma sees only in a kutastha, only in a changeless way, and no other way does the Atma see. Had Atma been seeing in a different way, then this way of seeing will be called secondary. Or, if Atma is taken as the fifth case, then, but the sixth case appears to be better, the fifth case if you take, then, Atmana Anyatha Drashtutvam, this is Drashtutvam, Atma Anyatha, so, if Drashta, then Atma Anyaha Drashta, if there was a Drashta other than Atma, then the So, darshan of the Atma can be called secondary, but there is no drashta other than the Atma. But I think what is meant here is that there is no seeing on the part of the Atma of a different kind. There is only one way in which Atma sees, and that is the kutastha drashti. There is no parinami drashti. Therefore, this kutastha darshanam alone is the primary, because there is no other one. That's what Anandagiri says, anyatha kutastha drashtitvam antarayane diyavata. Anyatha means, if they were seeing in a manner different from this kutastha drashtitvam, seeing in a changeless way, had they been there, then this would be secondary. What do you mean by darshana? Anyatha darshana prakara. Darshana prakarasya anyatvam kriyatmatvam. This is what it is. If Atma required an effort, so if Atma, this is one way of seeing on the part of Atma, changelessly seeing. Another way of seeing on the part of Atma, so changingly seeing. If such two seeings were there on the part of Atma, then one of them can be called secondary, other can be called primary. And then of course, the changing way of seeing would be called primary, because seeing is an act. So if there was a changing way of seeing, that Atma underwent a change while seeing, then that would be called primary, seeing on the part of Atma. But that kind of seeing is not there. Therefore, this cannot be called secondary. Secondary always is in with reference to primary. But there is no primary thing, there is no other thing with reference to which this can be called secondary. Therefore, this alone is primary seeing, so kutastha drashti. So darshana prakasa anyatvam kriyatmatvam. So kriyatmatvam, that kriya would be involved in seeing, then this kutastha seeing would be called gaunam. Anandagiri continues, tasya nishkriyatva shruti smriti virodhadi visheshah tasya kriyatmaka darshanasya atmanova. Atmanasya. Atmanah nishkriyatva. Nishkriyo nishkalo shanta. What is it then? So, nishkriyam nishkalam shantam. So, nishkriyam nishkalam shantam. Atma is called nishkriya. Shri Smriti Gita also says that. So, Atma is actionless. So niṣkriyatva śruti śruti virodhāt. Then if you impute kriya in the ātmā, then that would contradict the kriya. So niṣkriyatvam or the actionlessness of the ātmā. Or kriyātmaka darśanasya. If the seeing of the ātmā involved also kriya, then that also would contradict the very nature of ātmā, because ātmā also would become changing. And so if you impute any kind of a change either in the ātmā or in the seeing of the ātmā, then that would contradict these statements of the śruti and the smriti, which reveal the ātmā to be changeless. Iti śeṣaḥ. Drashtrutvāntara anupattau phalitamāha. Drashtrutvāntara, that there is no another drashta, there is another way of seeing. Anupattau, when it's not tenable, then there could be another drashta or there could be another way of seeing. Phalitamaha. So what is the result? Is being said, tadeva mevaiti. Says Vashyakara. Tadeva meva mukhyam drashtrutvam upapadyate na anyatha. Eva me, only in this manner, mukhyam drashtrutvam upadyate, it's only in this manner that drashtrutvam or the primary seeing also is there in no other way. There is no seeing that involves any kind of a change, therefore this is the only way of seeing, and therefore this way of seeing alone is primary. So kutastha drashtihi nanyatha. What is nanyatha? Footnote number 1. Nanyatha pratichaha akriyabodhasya sannidhi matrena sarva jagat pratitihi eva tad bhasakatvam nadu tad vikaradvara tathagat bhasakatve mana abhavat tad idam eva mukhyamidhi bhavah. Nicely says, footnote number 1, pratichaha of the pratyagatma, which is the innermost self, akriyabodhasya. So what is the nature of pratyagatma? Akriyabodha. Nature of bodha. Bodha means knowledge. Akriyabodha. So knowledge is actionless knowledge, changeless knowledge. So atma is the nature of changeless knowledge, changeless consciousness. Tasya sannidhi matrena. By the very sannidhi, by the very presence of the atma, sarva jagat pratirihi. Then there is a pratiti. Perception or cognition of the whole world is only because of the very presence of the atma, who is the nature of changeless consciousness. Nathat vikaradvara, it is not that atma has to do something to illumine the world, or that in the process of illumination that atma undergoes a change. The sun does not require to do anything to illumine the world, but sun undergoes a change anyway. That's what they tell us. That every year he is losing what? Some 10 degrees Fahrenheit or some such temperature. Millions of degrees are there, so it's not, but still, it's there. There's a change we can't notice. Like the warming, the global warming. When they talk of global warming, then every year the temperature rises. In what sense? It's a fraction of a fraction of a fraction of a degree. You can't even, it requires very sophisticated instruments. You want to measure that change. Still warming is there. Is 0.1 degree or 0.01 degree or some such thing, you know, who can measure it? But still, the world feels that. Except what happens this year is that they notice a 0.1 degree Fahrenheit change. Significant change. This year the warming was 0.1 degree Fahrenheit in the Pacific Ocean. So temperature of Pacific Ocean rose by 0.1 degree Fahrenheit. That is called El Niño, that's the effect, you know. And so all kinds of things happened in the world. By that 0.1 degree, all kinds of storms happened, all kinds of rains happened, and all kinds of droughts, famine also happened. So there were regions where there was unusual rain, there were unusual storms, and region where there was unusual drought. Because of El Niño, which is what? 0.1 degree Fahrenheit rise in the temperature of Pacific Ocean. So this is what. But anyway, change, the idea is that even sun also undergoes a change. That's the idea. Although we may not know, even that kind of change is not there in Atma. If Atma also is losing consciousness slowly and slowly because the poor thing is illumining everything, you know. And therefore there was a little, there was an exhaustion in consciousness, even at a slow rate. Then someday it will perish. Someday the sun will become, will be put off. That's what will happen. Someday. Put off. No light at all. We won't be around to see that day, but you can imagine that day happening.
When that day will be, nobody knows, because what happens to the sun is that, on one hand there is a loss of energy because of the energy is being radiated, on the other hand, there are so many reactions taking place, there are all kind of so exothermic reactions taking place, so heat keeps on being generated also. So how long will that process go on? I don't know, millions and millions and billions of years probably. So the kind of time span that we are talking about, the human lifespan is just nothing. Scientists sometimes get worried about the exhaustion of the mineral wealth of the earth, the way the human being is squandering the wealth. That's why they say, don't waste electricity, don't waste water, don't waste energy, don't do these things. You know, they keep saying that. Don't waste. So there's one thing, you see, I forget the words, you know, but there was one, in Hindi it was written, I don't know. But the, what it meant is that, my dear friend, don't run around unnecessarily. Save gasoline, you know. This was the idea. Save petrol bachana, you know. And so, some mat jana, altu faltu mat jana, petrol bachana, some other expression was there. So, because there's a concern that ultimately the future generation will be deprived. But anyway, the idea is that change takes place everywhere. But then, sannidhi matrena sarva jagat pratite pratidhi eva. So it is merely by the sannidhi of the atma that the whole world gets illumined, not tad vikara dvara. There is no vikara, no change whatever involved in the consciousness of the atma. Tathavida bhasakatve mana bhavat. There is no pramanam that the bhasakatvam, the illumination involves any kind of a change upon the atma. There is no manam, pramanam. Tasmat tat tasmat idam eva mukhyam iti bhavah. And therefore, this is the primary seeing and there is no other seeing. So, nanyatha. Nitya drushtitvena eva ityartha. Tat eva meva means what? Nitya drushtitvena eva. It's only by the nitya drushtitva that this is the seeing, that is seeing involved. Uktayate drushtandamaha. Bhashyakara gives an illustration to illustrate this yatha ityadina. Bhashya says,
yatha adityadinam prakashaitrutvam nityenaiva swabhavikena akriyamanena prakashena tadevacha prakashaitrutvam mukhyam prakashaitrutvantranupattehe.
If I just says, adityadinam, the luminaries of the sun and others, prakashetrutvam, nityenaiva, swabhavikena, akriyamanena, prakashena. The sun illumines by akriyamanena, prakashena, by the prakasha that is not brought into existence, swabhavikena, that remains, that obtains as the very nature of the sun, and not that is brought into existence by the sun. And it's only by the nature of being of the nature of natural illuminary, natural brightness or natural light, then the sun is called the illuminator. Tadevacha prakashetratvam mukhyam. So that, therefore, that is the primary illumination part of the sun. Prakashetratvantar anupattehe. The sun does not illumine in a different way. If sun illumines in a way different from this, then this can be called a secondary one. Or you can see if there was an illuminator other than sun who underwent a change, then also you can call this kind of changeless illumination in secondary one, but there is no, sun does not illuminate in any other way, or there is no illuminator other than sun who illumines in a different way also. Adityadinam, that includes all the luminaries. So wherever any illumination takes place, it always takes place by a light that is natural and uncreated and therefore undying. So says Anandji, tatha atmanopi drashtutvam nityeneva swabhavikena chaitanya jyotisha siddhati. Tatha similarly, atmanopi drashtutvam, even the seerness of the atma, nityeneva swabhavikena. So by the consciousness of nitya, nitya means eternal, swabhavikena uncreated, chaitanya jyotisha, the light that is of the nature of atma, so siddhati, that's how he is called drashta. Tadevacha drashtutvam mukhyam, and therefore that drashtutvam or that seerness is mukhyam, primary. Drashtutvantra anupattehe. There is no other way of illumination. There is no other illuminator and there is no other way of illumination. Both are there. That even the pramada also say to illumine, there also, in fact, no change is involved. The change is in the vritti and that change is imputed in the pramada. And therefore, there is no other way of illuminating.
Atmanah nitya drushti svabhavatve phalitamah.
Thus, when atma is nitya drushti svabhavah, what is phalitam? So, what is the ultimate result? Tasmadati.
Tasmat na drashtuhu drushtihi viparilupyate iti na pratisheda gandhopi asti.
Tasmat, therefore, footnote number 2, avatana uktatva, that is already said,
na drashtuhu drushtihi viparilupyate,
and therefore, the sight of the seer, it does not ever suffer a cessation or destruction. Iti, so what is iti? Iti atra. Na vipratisheda gandhavai pratisheda gandhopi asti. Therefore, pashyanvai, there is no vipratisheda, there is no contradiction involved. There is a seer and still does not change. Or, nahi drashtuhu drashtehe viparilobhavai. Even though he is a drashta, even though he is seer in a primary sense, not only in secondary sense, in the primary sense, even though Atma is seer, his sight does not suffer a cessation. And therefore, this is the, so, there is no vipratisheda. In saying that it is seer, and still his seeing is eternal, there is no contradiction at all. Na vipratisheda gandhobhyasti. Even the smell of the contradiction is not there. Okay, I think we'll go to the Krodhapatra tomorrow.
Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Balarayanam Sutra-bhāṣya-kṛtau vande bhagavantau punah punah Īśvaro-guru-rātmeti mūrti-bheda-vibhāgine vyoma-vajyāpta-dehāya dakṣinā-mūrtaye namah. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Hari Om.
Yadvaitanna Pashyate.
Pashyanvaitanna
Pashyate.
Nahi
Drashtur Drashter Viparilopo Vidyate.
Avinashitva
Nadu
Tadvidiyam
Asti
Tato Nyad Vibhaktam
Yat Pashyet
Yadvai
Tatra
Napashyadi
Pashyanvai
Tatra
Napashyadi
Tat
Napashyadi.
That
Atma
does not see in
the
deep sleep state, seeing in fact it does not see.
Nahi
drashtu drashter viparilobho
vidyate,
because the
sight
of the seer cannot suffer
a
destruction.
Avinashitvat,
because the
seer
atma is
avinashi,
therefore
the
sight
also
is avinashi.
Nudat
dvitiyam asti,
then
how come
it
does not see?
Nudat
dvitiyam
asti
yat
pashyet.
There is
no
that second
thing,
like
the pramata,
the
chidabhasa,
who will see?
Or
anyat
vibhaktam,
like
the prameya,
the pramana.
So
that
pramada,
prameya,
pramanam
is not there,
because
of which
the
atma
would see,
because
of
which the
visheshajnana
would take place,
and
so
that
does not see,
show
the absence of
visheshajnana,
and
that
it sees,
shows
the nature of
consciousness.
Now
we
can,
yesterday
of course
we
saw,
as to how the question was raised. How it is that on one hand you say that Atma is Drashta, and on the other hand you say that it is Avinashi, or the Drashti of this Atma is Avinashi. Drashtuhu sa Drashti na viparupyate iti vipratishaddham. Drashta is, so Drashti Karta. Drashti Karta is called Drashta. The agent of seeing is called the Drashta or the seer. And therefore, the seeing is something that is brought about by the seer. And therefore, it is Kritakam, something that is created. And what is created is still permanent. This is what you are saying. And that is contradictory. And even the words of the Veda also cannot change the nature of the things. Then the answer was given is no. Adityadi prakashakatvat darshano bhaktehe. This darshanam, the seeing of the Atma, is of the nature of the sun, seeing or illumining the whole world. How to illumine, how to shine is the nature of the sun. And by the virtue of shining, the sun illumines everything without an effort on its part. And so, if that illuminating required an action on the part of the sun, then it cannot be imperishable. But illuminating is not an action on the part of the sun, it is just being on the part of the sun. Therefore, yatha adityadayo nitya prakasha svabhavayava santaha svabhavikena nityaneva prakashena prakashyanti. The sun and the luminaries, they illumine because they are of the nature of brightness. Nahiya prakashatmana san prakasham kurva santaha prakasham kurvantaha prakashyanti uchyate. It is not that the sun is not so brightness by nature and then it becomes bright and illumines. In the sense that it is not the sun has to bring about a change in himself in order to illumine. Kimtari suhavaneva nityena prakashena prakashanti. In fact, they illumine everything by the light which is their own nature. Ayamapi atma avipariluptas suhavaya drishtya nitya drashta yuchyate. So also this atma is called drashta, seer, by the fact that seeing or illumining or shining or consciousness is its very nature. Gauram tarhi drishtutvam. That means that Atma is not a seer in the primary sense, he is a second seer in the secondary sense. In the primary sense, the pramada, that the knower should be called the seer, because seer is the one who was undergoing change with respect to what is seen. So then, vikaritvam. So, vikaritaya prakashakatvam. So, illuminating everything while undergoing change is looked upon as the primary seeing, and then vikaram vina prakashakatvam. So illuminating everything without undergoing a change is gaunam, is secondary seeing. Then very beautifully it is pointed out, na eva eva mukhyato upatte. He says, no, no. In fact, even when pramada also illumines, no change is really involved. So this was told. That darshanopadehe vrittyeva chakshuradijanyataya pramadari tathapratidhi aupadhiki. That pramada or drashta also appears to be changing. It is because the vritti, the chakshushi, or any vritti that takes place on account of the organs of perception, so any vritti that takes place of a particular prameya or the object, it is that vritti that changes, and therefore the pramada also is thought to be changing. Vastu dastu vritti hai vastu pramana sambandha matra adhina janyata na pramatra kati sadhyatvam. In fact, the vritti like ghatakara, patakara vritti also is not something that is brought about by pramada. For that vritti like ghatakara vritti to arise, all that happens is that the eyes in this case come in contact with the ghata, and automatically the vritti arises. Therefore, there is no effort involved on the part of the pramada or the knower even to create that vritti. Pramampadi kartrutvivaharastu chit darshanasya pramampadi kartrutvivaharastu pramotpatti anukula vishendriya sammandha anukula kritimatvat. And so, we say kartrutva or pramatratva. Pramampadi kartrutvam. The agency of the effort involved, so that this is an agent of knowing. Who is the pramata? So, pramampadi karta. One who brings about the knowledge. So, we call him pramata. We call him knower, thus imputing a sense of agency by this trishpatya. Even that also, pramam prati kartrutva viharastu pramotpatti anukul. All that the pramada does whatever activity or action that is required, to bring about a contact of the organ of perception with the sense object. That's all. So real activity, the only activity involved in the part of the knower is to bring about this contact. And subsequently the knowledge or cognition takes place. In that process, no effort is involved on the part of Pramada. And therefore, so Pramatari Kartrutva Viharasa Aupacharikaiva. Even in the Pramata also, that he is knowing, that he performs an act of knowing. He does not perform an act of knowing. He performs an act of opening the eyes. He performs an act of directing the eyes to the object concerned. And then he performs an action which is required to bring about a contact with the sense organ, of the sense organ with the sense object. But he does not perform an action with reference to cognition to take place. That a ghatakara vritti takes place, that a thought of the nature of ghata takes place, is not of the doing of the pramata. That is something that happens automatically. And therefore, with reference to prama, when we call him pramata, that means that there is a pramam prati karta. That he is a karta or a doer with reference to cognition. Pramam means cognition. So cognizer is pramata. And so cognizer automatically implies grammatically that he does something for the cognition to take place. The answer is no. Even a cognizer also does not do anything to create the cognition. He does whatever is required to create conditions for the cognition to take place. This is how it is in knowledge, that one has to create conditions for the knowledge to take place. Even a sadhaka, a seeker also creates conditions for the knowledge to take place. And so, sadhana, chatushtha, sampatti, shama, dama, uparama, all of these one does, as we said, for the mind to become an abiding mind, abiding in the self. And then shravana, manana, nirindhyasaram. This is what he does in terms of the nature of vichara. So atma vichara he does. And so vedantartha vicharana jayate jnanam uttamam. It is by the vichara of the vedantartha. So vedanta tatparya, that jnanam takes place. And so even for atma jnanam also to arise, no effort is involved on the part of pramata. In fact, he must give up all the effort. That's why Bhashyakara or Shankaracharya would then insist that there must be renunciation of all action. That means renunciation of all effort. There must be anasakti, total anasakti. There will be knowledge to take place. If some kind of concern is there, that means some activity is going to be involved. Even that also should be dropped completely. And so, whenever any cognition takes place, there is no action involved on the part of the cognizer. किंच चेतनश्चेतनानाम इत्यादि श्रुते आत्मद्रष्टुत्वा द्रष्टुत्वाधीनमेव प्रमातुः द्रष्टुत्वम्. एंड सपोज यू से दैट दिस प्रमाता, देयर इज अ कॉग्नाइजर, यू दैट देयर इज अ कॉग्नाइजर ऑफ द कॉग्नाइजर. श्रोत्रस्य श्रोत्रम मनसः मनः. सो श्रोत्र देयर मींस अ श्रोता. एंड सो देयर इज अ श्रोता ऑफ द श्रोता, एंड मंता ऑफ द मंता, एंड विज्ञाता ऑफ द विज्ञाता. That means a shruta is a shruta on account of the consciousness of the Atma. That the hearer is a hearer. That is because the real illumination takes place by the self. And therefore, so Atma drashtutva dhinameva pramatuhu drashtutvam. In fact, the real drashta, the real seer is nothing but none other than Atma. It is because Atma sees or illumines that the eyes are able to see. Or what we call drashta is able to see. The shrota is able to hear. The manta is able to think. And therefore, the real seeing and thinking is only on the part of the Atma. Had he not been there, Pramata would not have been able to do anything. And therefore, in fact, the drashtutvam, the seeing on the part of the seer is gavanam, and seeing on the part of the Atma is pradhanam. So said, tasmat na drushtehe na drashtuhu drushtihi viparilupyade idena vipradesheda gandhopyasti. Therefore, that there is the drashti never suffers a cessation, there is no contradiction, because drashti is not something that is created, drashti is something that is natural. प्रकाशयितृत्वम् आदित्यादिन नित्येनैव स्वाभाविकेनैव स्वाभाविकेन अक्रियमाणेन प्रकाशेन. The prakash of the light that is not brought into existence is by that light that sun and others illumine, and source is the consciousness that is not brought into existence, that is naturally existent. It is by that consciousness that Atma illumines everything. Now we go back to all the way. Where are we? 1125. Then you have to turn around. Nahi drashtuhu drashtehe ityadau vartike. Nahi drashtuhu drashtehe viparilobo vidyade avinashitvat. With reference to this, this is what we just discussed. So this is, Vartikara has this to say about it. And now of all these verses, the explanation is to be found on the following page. Page 1126 in the fifth line. After iti pratignyavakyam patadvaya vivyakhyaya hetu vakyam anudya tatasya arthamaha. Pratignyavakyam patadvaya vivyakhyaya. So pashyanvai na pashyade, this is pratignyavakyam. Yadvaitan na pashyade iti manyase janik.